Okay. Now you gotta watch, it kinda smears it around. If you don't watch, you have to keep using a new place on your paper towel because it actually smears it around a little bit. It's real easy to make a mess with CA. Okay, that took it right off. Got CA in my holes. I'm gonna let that dry and come back to this one. So I set this to the side for right now. I grab my other wing. Okay. Okay, I start off by drilling my servo horn out where it will accept my clevis. Drill it from both sides. Make it fairly straight. And you can always take the servo horn off and put it on a piece of wood or whatever, or hold it in your hand if you're careful, and drill it, okay? That'll allow me to clip my clevis end on it, the one that I threaded on my control rods earlier. And sometimes these take a little bit to clip them in. Okay, I take a little bit of tape, and you can do this at either end of the aileron. You get it really close. I just tape my aileron in place to keep it fairly straight while I'm fooling with it. This helps a lot. A friend of mine uses little clamps. They work well too. Okay, I set my horn on here. And I center it. Now again, they put a piece of plywood in the aileron, right there at the spot where your horn goes. I want to line my servo horn up with my linkage that I have sitting here. And I also want to line the holes up, centered on the middle of the hinge. Okay. Appears to be it. Now take a little time to get this right. If you go too quickly on this, you'll find that you made a mistake, usually. Hold it in place firmly. Drill a hole. And a lot of times it'll move a little bit when you drill your hole. So you really gotta hold on to it firmly. You gotta really try to pay attention to make it stay in place. Now I'm gonna take one screw. I'm gonna put in that one hole that I just drilled. And you have to be careful not to, if you slip on this type of stuff, you're gonna make a hole in your covering that you're gonna have to repair. So be careful. Take your time, hold on to your tools. Now, I need to check, make sure that nothing moved. Make sure everything's still lined up the way I want it. Appears to be. Okay, drill another hole. Try to stay perpendicular to the angle of your aileron slant. When drilling your holes, try not to go to the other side. Just go through the spot you need to go through. See, that one was angled there. It really won't hurt anything. There's not that much I can do about it. It was the way my bit went. Go my other two holes. Put in two more screws. Again, I don't have to run them up tight. I run them in about 3/4 of the way. Back them back out. Okay. One drop of CA in each hole. I'll be a little more careful this time not to make a mess. One drop in each hole is plenty. Okay. Now I'm gonna let that one dry for a minute. Now, actually my other wing should be dry enough to my horn on. Let me see. It appears to be. Good. All the way up tight with my little drill. I probably could on these on a one setting. I'll try it. If it will kick out on a one setting when they're fairly tight, I could probably get by with it. I usually don't. Make sure the bit's fitting your head well. Yeah, it actually works. These are a little bigger screws. Clutch, it's pretty accurate. Don't over tighten them. You just want to start indenting the wood. That's tight enough. Okay, now let's look at our book. It looks like they're showing that you're going to hook in these in the second hole down.
Best country is right here on 1029 The Z. Frankie Ballard and Hell of a Life getting us underway in the 2 o'clock hour. Luke Bryan coming up.
So, I drill Jamie O'Neill, there is no my second air hole down. I drill it out. 1029 The Z. Those are a little closer to the right size. Okay, I take my solder clevis in and I lay it beside my linkage. I'm going to go in the second hole and I get a Sharpie pen. Okay, I lay it right there. Actually, I'm going to clip it on. They're showing it in the book to be in the second hole. on these horns. I put it in the second hole. Snap it into place. Just for accuracy. I lay my linkage right beside it. And again, I like my link to be right to these little ears on the clevis. So I mark it. Okay. Now, I clip it, and when you clip these, be very careful to hold on to the other end. Otherwise, it'll shoot across the room, which it's kind of hard to do. I'm going to take that one off to do it. Now, when you pop these clevises loose, they're kind of tight. So, is what I do is I take my hemostats, and if you put them between them, and then roll them over, they'll pop that end loose, and then you can take the other end and pry it out very carefully not to damage your hardware. Make something hard fairly easy. Okay, I do it again. I put it in there. I turn it. It pops that end loose. I grab a hold of the other end. Wiggle it. These can be very tight, and if you're trying to do it with your fingernails, you're going to be popping your fingernails left and right. Okay, now, I'm going to clip my control rod off at my mark. Okay. I keep these little pieces, use them for all kinds of things. Now, this little sharp end, I usually go ahead and sand them off. On these, it wouldn't matter that much. But I sand them off anyway. On most linkages, if you have a piece of the linkage sticking out, sure enough, you're going to hang it and cut your finger or something at some point. So, I take my little sanding pad and I sand them off. I found out the other day from a tip that you can actually take paint stir sticks, and I like the heavy duty stir sticks that you get at Home Depot, but you can use the lighter weight ones, and regular sandpaper, and you can just glue with some kind of adhesive, spray adhesive or whatever, or adhesive back sandpaper, and you can put it on those sticks and make similar little sanding blocks. These are great plane sanding blocks. They're very handy. Although, I had the longer one and I didn't like it. It was too long. The short one's handy for everything. They sell the sandpaper. It's kind of high. It's really good quality. Very handy building tool. Okay, I round off my sharp edge. Now, fit it up into my solder end. I'm going to mark it again. Now I want to check this just by setting it up here. I'm going to check and see if my link's about right. By lining up to the holes that you're going to use. Across the great plains, and all the angels up in heaven, you can see about where you need to solder it. Now I cut this one a little long. Which is fine because I can thread it up on the other end. I mark it. And then I want to sand this little spot that I'm going to be soldering. I want to sand it. I want to roughen it up a little bit. So I take my sanding block. This particular manual says that it has some tips on soldering, so I'm going to look at that too and see what they say. Most manuals don't. They just say, scuff it up and solder it. A little easier said than done. It's not complicated, is all you need is a solder gun and some solder. But you really want to do it right so these don't come loose on you. Okay, I got one there ready to go. Got one ready to go. Now, technically, I could make my other one off of this one. I don't do that. It would be close and it would probably work, but I actually fit each one per each one. That way I don't ever make the mistake. I've actually come up with them of being a little different. So, there's that one. Yeah. Go to this wing. Drill my second hole. I'm going to be using my second hole on this horn, so I want to drill it out where it will fit my clevis. Okay, I use a 1/16 drill bit for these particular ones. Okay. Okay. Now you gotta watch, it kinda smears it around. If you don't watch, you have to keep using a new place on your paper towel because it actually smears it around a little bit. It's real easy to make a mess with CA. Okay, that took it right off. Got CA in my holes. I'm going to let that dry and come back to this one. So I set this to the side for right now. I grab my other wing. Okay. Okay, I start off by drilling my servo horn out where it will accept my clevis. Drill it from both sides. Make it fairly straight. And you can always take the servo horn off and put it on a piece of wood or whatever, or hold it in your hand if you're careful, and drill it, okay? That'll allow me to clip my clevis in on it, the one that I threaded on my control rods earlier. And sometimes these take a little bit to clip them in. Okay, I take a little bit of tape, and you can do this at either end of the aileron to get it really close. I just tape my aileron in place to keep it fairly straight while I'm fooling with it. This helps a lot. A friend of mine uses little clamps, they work well too. Okay, I set my horn on here. And I center it. Now again, they put a piece of plywood in the aileron, right there at the spot where your horn goes. I want to line my servo horn up with my linkage that I have sitting here. And I also want to line the holes up, centered, on the middle of the hinge. Okay? That appears to be it. It'll take a little time to get this right. If you go too quickly on this, you'll find that you made a mistake, usually. Hold it in place firmly. Drill a hole. And a lot of times it'll move a little bit when you drill your hole. So you really gotta hold on to it firmly. You gotta really try to pay attention to make it stay in place. Now I'm gonna take one screw. I'm gonna put in that one hole that I just drilled. And you have to be careful not to, if you slip on this type of stuff, you're gonna make a hole in your covering that you're gonna have to repair. So be careful. Take your time, hold on to your tools. Now, I need to check, make sure that nothing moved. Make sure everything's still lined up the way I want it. Appears to be. Okay, drill another hole. Try to stay perpendicular to the angle of your aileron slant. When drilling your holes, try not to go to the other side. Just go through the spot you need to go through. That one was angled there. It really won't hurt anything. There's not that much I can do about it. It was the way my bit went. Go my other two holes. Put in two more screws. Again, I don't have to run them up tight. I run them in about 3/4 of the way. Back them back out. One drop of CA in each hole. I'll be a little more careful this time not to make a mess. One drop in each hole is plenty. Okay. Now I'm let that one dry for a minute. Now, actually my other wing should be dry enough to put my horn on. Let me see. It appears to be good. All the way up tight with my little drill. I probably could on these on a one setting. I'll try it. If it will kick out on a one setting when they're fairly tight, I could probably get by with it. I usually don't. Make sure the bit's fitting your head well. Yeah, it actually works. These are a little bigger screws. Clutch, it's pretty accurate. Don't over tighten them. You just want to start indenting the wood. That's tight enough. Okay. Now, let's look at our book. It looks like they're showing that you're going to hook in these in the second hole down.
Best country is right here on 1029 the Z, Frankie Ballard, and hell of a life getting us underway in the 2 o'clock hour. Luke Bryan coming up.
So, I drill Jamie O'Neill, there is no my second hole down. I drill it out.
1029 the Z.
Those are a little closer to the right size. Okay, I take my solder clevis in and I lay it beside my linkage. I'm going the second hole and I get a Sharpie pen. Okay, I lay it right there. Actually, I'm going to clip it on. They're showing it in the book to be in the second hole. On these horns, I put it in the second hole, snap it into place, just for accuracy. I lay my linkage right beside it, and again, I like my link to be right to these little ears on the clevis, so I mark it. Okay. Now, I clip it, and when you clip these, be very careful to hold on to the other end. Otherwise, it'll shoot across the room, which it's kind of hard to do. I'm going to take that one off to do it. Now, when you pop these clevises loose, they're kind of tight. So, is what I do is I take my hemostats, and if you put them between them, and then roll them over, they'll pop that end loose, and then you can take the other end and pry it out very carefully not to damage your hardware. Make something hard fairly easy. Okay, I do it again, I put it in there, I turn it, it pops that end loose. I grab a hold of the other end, wiggle it. These can be very tight, and if you're trying to do it with your fingernails, you're going to be popping your fingernails left and right. Okay, now, I'm going to clip my control rod off at my mark. Okay. I keep these little pieces, use them for all kinds of things. Now, this little sharp end, I usually go ahead and sand them off. On these, it wouldn't matter that much, but I sand them off anyway. On most linkages, if you have a piece of the linkage sticking out, sure enough, you're going to hang it and cut your finger or something at some point, so. I take my little sanding pad and I sand them off. I found out the other day from a tip that you can actually take paint stir sticks, and I like the heavy-duty stir sticks that you get at Home Depot, but you can use the lighter weight ones, and regular sandpaper, and you can just glue with some kind of adhesive, spray adhesive or whatever, or adhesive back sandpaper, and you can put it on those sticks and make similar little sanding blocks. These are great planes sanding blocks. They're very handy. Although, I had the longer one and I didn't like it. It was too long. The short one's handy for everything. They sell the sandpaper. It's kind of high. It's really good quality. Very handy building tool. Okay, I round off my sharp edge. Now, fit it up into my solder end. I'm going to mark it again. Now I want to check this just by setting it up here. I'm gonna check and see if my link's about right. By lining up to the holes that you're gonna use. You can see about where you need to solder it. Now I cut this one a little long. Which is fine, because I can thread it up on the other end. I mark it. And then I want to sand this little spot that I'm going to be soldering. I want to sand it. I want to roughen it up a little bit. So I take my sanding block. This particular manual says that it has some tips on soldering, so I'm going to look at that too and see what they say. Most manuals don't. They just say, scrub it up and solder it. A little easier said than done. It's not complicated, as all you need is a solder gun and some solder. But you really want to do it right so these don't come loose on you. Okay, I got one there ready to go. Got one ready to go. Now, technically, I could make my other one off of this one. I don't do that. It would be close and it would probably work, but I actually fit each one per each one. That way I don't ever make the mistake. I've actually come up with them of being a little different. So, there's that. Yeah. Let's go to this wing. Drill my second hole. I'm going to be using my second hole on this horn, so I want to drill it out where it will fit my clevis. Okay, I'm going to use a 1/16 drill bit for these particular ones. Okay. Bit in, making sure it fits my hardware good. Set my control horn in the place where it goes. Sometimes it's easier to thread your screw in a little bit when you send it over your hole. Run it down just a little bit. Not too tight, just tight enough to slightly start pulling down the wood, okay? Here we go. Set my clevis up next to it. I'm going in the second hole. I want to mark it right at the ears on the clevis. Okay. Now, I pop it off of this ear. I put my emos in there and I pop it loose, and then I grab the other end and I pry it out very carefully. And when you're doing this type of stuff, it's really easy to damage your covering, and you really have to watch not to. Okay, here we go. I got my mark. Cut it off. Sand it down. my sharp end. Otherwise, I'll be bleeding. Pretty easy to do. Okay, double check everything by just setting it up beside it. Okay, that one came out a little bit different. They always will. I might have cut that one a hair short, but it won't matter. Here we go. I've got my marked place for my clevis on my solder end. Take my sanding block. I scuff up my spot that I'm getting ready to solder. Actually, you probably need to go ahead and scuff up a little bit below it also, because your solder is going to come out both ends. Okay, scuff it up a little bit. Get my soldering gun out and stuff. Let's solder them. Let's read their solder tip first. Expert tip, how to solder.
I like that song. Coming up, we got brand new music from Rascal Flatts. Here's Jared Demon, Drink to That All Night, 102.9 The Z.
It says, use denatured alcohol or other solvent to thoroughly clean the push rod. Roughen the end of the push rod with coarse sandpaper where it's to be soldered. Apply a few drops of soldering flux to the end of the push rod and then use a soldering iron or torch to heat it or tin it. The silver solder by applying the solder to the end. The heat of the push rod should melt the solder. Do not flame solder, thus allowing the solder to flow. Well, I don't do it exactly like that. I'll show you how I do it. First of all, I get a little box or something to set it up on. This is an engine box from an empty engine box from another plant I built. Get my solder gun out. And this is a little Weller. It's a real nice gun. It works great, but I have found that the soldering tips don't last long at all. So you need to get some other tips. Now, okay, one of my ends, I set my, actually, first of all, I tin them and set them up here. I clip them on to some hemostats, hold them up where I want them. Put it over the box, heat up my gun, get it good and hot. I usually just watch until it starts smoking good. Okay, there, it's getting good and hot. I heat up my surface a little bit. Apply a very small amount of solder. We call this tinning. Okay, try to do that. Heat it back up. Actually set my clevis on it. Hold all the way on because the solder is kind of heat it back up. Push it on. Ah, pushed it too far. Heat it back up. Now this, a lot of times your marks go away. So if you keep an eye on where it was located on this little clip, you'll be pretty close. And as you can see, this is a fairly tricky little deal. You can heat it up and push it, or pull it. Now I remember this one came a little past. Those little ears. So I go back to that. Okay, now I've got it in there. I've got it tin. Now I'm going to go ahead and apply a little bit of solder. I'm going to heat it up. Reverse these wheels, go back and re-pick you up. Went by so fast, oh so sweet. Make me want to re-make a memory. Wish I had me a time machine. Now it's hard to do much perfection in the way this looks. If it ends up a little lumpy or something, you can go right ahead and sand off your lumps. It's not that big a deal. I try to get a little bit on the top and bottom. I try to keep it right where I want it. So that's pretty close. Again, I've got some adjustment if I don't get it exactly right. Heat up my gun. Now this time I don't want to get everything as hot because I don't want to actually move it enough to flow in my solder. Okay. Pretty close. Now it's hard not to breathe this stuff, you should and see how all the excess ran off the bottom there. It's not bad. Blow on it to cool it down a little bit. And I like to get just a little bit of a lump on this back end to keep it from pulling through. But again, I don't want to heat it up that much. I just want to put my solder on it. Now like a little lump on the front. Okay, there it is. I didn't heat it up that much, but I did get a little bit on each side. Okay, now I can cool it down. It doesn't look perfect. Should be plenty strong. Again, I don't use flux. I use resin core wire. The smaller wire works great. There we go. That's one. Let's do another one. Clip on my hemostats. That way I've got a way of holding it. I'm going to go ahead and heat up my gun. I'm going to go ahead and tin it a little bit, which is just getting it hot and letting the solder flow a little bit over it. Don't want to use much solder.
Beatles Arc's Best Country, 1029 the Z, Gary, Jay, and Joe.
I actually used a little more than I needed.
Flat and rewind.
You can kind of pull solder off of there that you want off there with the solder gun.
And we will take a look at 1029.
You realize everything's pretty hot.
On the Shotgun Steve Kelly Midday Show, on the station that gives Green Power Starship Song.
Okay, got a little bit of tinning. I'm going to go just a little bit more.
In honor of Cupid and Valentine's Day, we're having a Valentine's Day bids for bargain sale now.
Just want a little bit of solder on it. Okay, remember your position on this one. You get it before it cools down, you can push that one right on. So I heat it up. Okay, push that one.
Shop Frenzy and Kids Frenzy for your special Valentine. We have an outstanding selection of jewelry, missing jeans, peacock.
Push that clever song where I want it.
Valentine, Kids Frenzy has stuffed animals and brand names such as Mud Pie and Animal Ren, and many fun accessories. Check out our Facebook or call for special Valentine gift packages.
This one I actually cut probably a hair short. So remembering that, I put it about the same place on those little ears. Okay, now I want to put a little lump on both ends, but I don't really want to heat everything up enough to make it fall off or move.
Dazzling diamonds that shimmer and dance, starting at only 119. 24 karat gold roses for 70.
There it is. A little lump on either side. After it cools the hair, I flip it over. Do the same thing.
And color gemstone jewelry.
Not trying to heat everything up. Just trying to heat up a little bit. A little bit of solder. Put my little lump on the end.
Hi, my name's Elaine Fisher. Wanted to tell you about Anybody's Garage. My son was here from Wisconsin on vacation, and this excursion was acting up. We called Jeff, said, Jeff, can we bring it in? He said, you betcha, and took care of us on time, on schedule, and always guarantees his work.
Sometimes it's a little hard to get it to lay just right where you want it.
Pick Anybody's Garage.
Across from Snap Beard Funeral Home.
And of course, in the process, you'll heat everything up too much, and you'll have a big slug of solder laying down. So you just pull it off with your gun. It'll just pull it right off there. Let it cool a little bit. Go back to it.
Life, you are not alone. 1 in 6 adult women suffer from bladder control. Taylor Surgical Arts can help give
you. Said I like a little bit of a lump on either end.
Therapy for urinary control has helped thousands gain control of their bladder problems since 1987. This outpatient procedure is covered by all insurance companies, Medicare and Medicaid. Learn about the trial assessment and reclaim control by contacting Taylor Surgical Arts 870-741-1616.
Check that I didn't mess up my other end, my other side, which I did.
Has the answer. Chocolate treatments for Valentine's Day. Order her the exclusive bundle, which includes 1 dozen chocolate-covered strawberries from the cake shop at a $100 gift certificate.
This there it is.
To any Harrison business.
Number two.
Valentine's Day. You'll be her hero by showing her you recognize she needs a break. Call 870-743-7327. Premier Day Spa this Valentine's.
Now, you can knock any little lumps off with your iron heated up, just brush across them, or you can go ahead and wait and sand it off. It sands pretty easily when you get done. Okay, set your soldering iron aside, let it cool down, make sure it doesn't get against anything. And like I said, you're going to go through, if you do this very much, you're going to go through quite a few tips. The tips don't seem to last long. At least the Weller tips don't. I guess I need to order heavier duty tips. Those tips are mainly for electrical. And when you're doing electrical, you don't heat them up near as much. Okay. Now, I inspect my ends, and if they're a little lumpy, I sand off my lumps a little bit until they look the way I want them.
Had more borrowed sunshine, patchy clouds, not as cold in the afternoon, a high 39. Thursday is mostly sunny and milder, high 52. I'm ActiveWeather.com, meteorologist.
Solder sands pretty easy, so you can dress them up pretty easy with some coarse sandpaper.
Currently 28 degrees here at the 1029.
And a sanding block of any kind.
Presented by Bits for Bargains at 1029.
Just to knock the tops off of them and make them where they don't look bad.
Valentine's Day Bits for Bargains sale now through February the 14th. When you spend $50 or more, simply use the code word LOVE and save 10% on your entire purchase. For more details on Bits for Bargains, go to 1029thez.com and let the savings begin. It's a sweetheart of a deal.
And of course, I pull around on them and stuff, make sure that